Hello guys, this is the second part of that video where we are making a form using PHP and HTML. So if you have followed the first part of our video, then you might have got the output as just a single page, and when you click the submit button, so nothing happens, actually nothing happens. So if anything to happen, this is the main code part of the code. That was just a form using HTML PHP, and this is the complete PHP code. So this will just post your data, this will just take your data and just save it in your PHP MyAdmin as a table. So I'll start here by showing you how to create a table, and then I'll tell you. So here, when we go to our localhost PHP MyAdmin, so here is a account table, and in the same way you can make a table here, like anything. You want to create a table of what? Suppose register, register, and will the fields 3 for one for number of fields will be 3, one for ID, second one for username, and third one for password. So like 3 over here, and then go. So it will make a table whose name will be register, and number of fields will be 3, and here we will get a wait for a second, actually it's working. Okay, so here we will get the options, what will be the table. So wait for a second. So yeah, I think something is going. Yeah, it comes over here, the three fields, one, the second, and the third. The three fields are here. What will the field? First will be ID, the second will be username, and the third will be password. So it will be hint, values, default, and all those are, yeah, it will be auto incrementing. It will just count the people, number of people which have been just registered to your site. So it will be auto increment, and it will be primary key. Here you have to set it as primary, that's it. And here username will be varchar. If you know SQL little bit, so you'll know what is varchar. And varchar, you should just give a number limit to 60, anything you can write. And then the password will be type of varchar, so you have it over here. And then something, anything, and I think that's, and null, no null. So that's it. And after that, you just have to come down, save it. Wait, man, save it. And when I press save, so what happens? A table will be created of three fields: ID, username, and password. Yay! See on the left hand side here, table with ID, username, and password have been created. So when we click it, table demo register has been created. And here's the code, forget about the code. And that's it. So now we can start our coding then. Where was this? Here we have just, when you write a PHP file, so you have to start in this way. Starting tag, a question mark, and a PHP. This is just starting, and this is the end of PHP. So this is how you end PHP, write a PHP file, and here we have defined the variable, a variable named demo, and the second variable root. Oh yeah, and the root is DB user, database user. So username, whatever the username of your database will be, you write it, whatever. And then PAKAUCHAND is PAKUCHAND, is my password. Localhost is the DB host, whatever the host will be, you write yours. And here the link is MySQL Connect. DB host, it's using this complete, is using the variable name. DB host is the variable name, drop off, DB user, DB password. And if link is not, this symbol over here, it says if link is not available, die, means it will just die the page. So redirect the page to a die of 404 or something like MySQL error, and it will show you a error in short. And here DB select database selected, MySQL select database name link, it's a variable over here. And here one more thing, that's the name of our database. So and link is from this host user password. So if DB selector is not there, not present, so die with MySQL error. And here are the value host username host. We have used host over here, where method host over here. So from this post will receive our data value as post username. Our name was username over there, and password as a password. This name, the name you wrote in the first part here, the name this or this, these are taken reference in this page here. So you get, you take that username and password in one variable, and then you save it. And then what happens, SQL insert into account. So insert into account is a different table for me. So our table was register, username, password, values, value 1, it will just respectively say that. And then if MySQL query SQL is not present, die with MySQL error. And here MySQL close, it will close the connection with PHP and MySQL. And here you close the PHP file. And finally, I have just wrote anything, whatever you can write, whatever you want successfully, and whatever you want to write, you know, HTML type of thing, you can write it over here. So we have saved this file. And then when we come to auth form, we have saved this file as authform.php. It is being saved in xampp, htdocs, and then xampp, then authform.php. So now when we come over here on our browser, and when we type localhost xampp, press enter, so what comes, wait for a second, I think it's just coming. 3, 2, 1. Actually this is the first part video speech, and the come to the second part video speech. So now I'll show you whatever the result will be. So like you can user entering in your website, you may have username as user, user And then the password can be anything, PA assistant to RP. And then he'll click submit over here after writing this data. He will be redirected to see here our auth fill, here file name is auth fill.php, and then when he clicks submit over here, he will be redirected to authform.php. You can see it over here. He is being redirected to authform.php. Congrats and login successfully. Login with other account. And when we come over here and check, MySQL return an empty set that is 0. Oh, something went wrong. I don't know. No, nothing went wrong actually. We got our first username as user and password. And the same way you can play with it. Login with another account. When he'll click it, he'll be redirected to first page. And like suppose Alok Sharma, and my password will be Sharma. And when I click submit, so again it redirected me to the new page. And when I go there on my PHP admin and refresh here, and see something will happen. First user word, and then wait for a second, it's just refreshing, it's taking time. Yay, Alok Sharma and Sharma. Here the password, here's the second user, and that's it. I think that will do your work. And thank you. Please subscribe us so that we will create more and more videos related to this topic, and you can get more information about PHP and HTML and this coding languages. Please subscribe.